broadcast live.
From Nasty C's Juice Back in 2014 to DJ Speedsta's 2018 hit Combos Communicating, Gemini's multi-award winning productions are often unmatched. In this episode of The Recipe, Gemini takes us through how he cooked up Do Better for Major League.
For the story of a song, actually, Major League asked me for an African beat, you know, and that time we were having a lot of sessions. They just wanted, you know, like Afro groove, you know, they love that way, you know. So when I remember that time when it was like that song Bana was like one of the hardest songs, it's just like. Baby Bana, I say like cassava, I got to be cassava, baby Bana. You know, he was going crazy, came to my studio, he's like, yo, Gemini. And he sang me like this, you know. So I started the beat on the spot. He slept in the studio. So the next morning when I played this, the beat sounded a whole lot more better. So I finished it. And then I sent it to him. And then he sent it to Clyde. Then Clyde did the chorus. And he sent me back the vocals and stuff, you know. That's when I took it back to the studio and changed some of the arrangements. The song initially started with the verse. And then I reversed it and started with the chorus. And we arranged it properly, sent to Sebs. Yeah, and the song was done. My love lives long like a bitch. I listen to your words like scripture. I know your heart's taken by the mist, but you can do better. If you break your heart, baby, I'll fix you. What more can I do to convince you? I know your heart's taken by the mist. Most of his beat, I used fiber. I went on and found like extra expansions for my guitars just to give it more live element, because initially Nexus is a synthesizer, so a lot of its sounds are like synths and so digital. Nexus, which is like a VST plugin, you can go ahead and look it up on the internet. If you do have it, I suggest get extra expansions, of which my Nexus didn't come like this. I had to like source out some of the like expansions and stuff. I feel like the most important part of the beat is having the right sounds, you know. I also use Purity mostly for the pads and the plugs. You know, and there's a lot of cool sounds in Purity. It's really an old VST. It's one of like the first VSTs I've ever used. Out of like my old sounds that I started with, it's the only one that's still here. It's just like the sounds that it has. And then there's just other things like riffs and stuff. Like you see like this is like, you can always find like key of your song, and there's some things that the sounds that you can't really, you know, play them, like drawing them, or like, you know, with this VSTs. So sometimes I go on and outsource samples, and with that key I find all the samples with that key, and then you find some really cool stuff without having to like sample a whole song or anything, you know. Show you the instruments one by one, how the sound, as you can see, the kicks here. Let me explain actually the kicks. As you can see here, this kick says kick bad too. This is actually, I chopped this off the baddest, aka his baddest. This kick here, it's the same one that's there. I just like the way the beat knocks when it comes in the groove. So I had it like a long time ago. I just chopped it to put it as one of my like a regular drums that I use, and I layered two kicks. That one there, because this one now I had like a higher end to it, and I just needed something to give it like more oomph. Then I added this one, which is not as loud as that one, but has got the elements of what that one is missing. So I usually do that and layer up two kicks to make it sound better. So I added that, which is like comes in with the lower end to it, and when you play them together, they sounded a lot more solid. Then there are the pads. And here's your snare. And of course the bass. And that's your guitar when you add the guitar. And then there's that. which is Purity. It's got really dope, like, plug sounds. Can you hear this one? It's digital, but like, depends on how you use it. It's got really cool sounds. So how I built this beat, if I have to remember, I think I might have started with the drums. I might have started with this groove here. I think that's how I started the beat. I had this pattern because, I mean, initially that's how, that's the inspiration around the song, was Afro, you know? So I started with the Afro simple, like typical Afro drum kit. No, then after that, that's when I started looking for melody, and the first melody I made was the chords. Yeah, so that's like a basic four bar loop that I had with the chords, and I said I didn't play them, I drew them. No, let's just do that. But obviously you need to know the keys for that. So yeah, when I did that, so that's what I had. And then I added a groove, which is a guitar from Nexus also. And that's when I added this. After I did that, I wanted that Afro bounce to it, and that's when I went to Purity and I added this. So I'm just gonna play it without the pads and stuff. So I added this. Yeah, but that's how it sounded alone. So I just wanted it to be a little more stronger and more present. So I went to a Nexus again. I added a guitar underneath it, which is like a harmonics guitar, and another Nexus expansion. It doesn't really come with it. You always need to add, like, you can buy the extensions or you can download them, a lot of presets online and expansions that you can find. So it's a guitar expansion. So I used the harmonic guitar there, put it there. Then I also added an organ, just to layer them up and really just like give it more presence, you know. And so together with the chords and the other guitars, how it sounded. Yeah, that's how I started to beat. Obviously, without the arrangement, the beat was all in one pattern. That's why the beat, I'm saying I started the beat like that, but it doesn't sound like that in the song. Simply because when I was satisfied with everything I had, then I can break it down, you know. And so after I had this, I added the sub bass. The sub bass, I really like struggled with it. Like I kept on going back and forth to find it. The right one, but I set it for this one, which is like a basic also cyan bass from from Nexus. So I used a lot of Nexus mostly, and when I added the sound bass, and that's how it sounded after I added the bass. And the rest was just like adding like more percussions, obviously, just to make your beat, you know, more groovier, you know, more groovier and busier. And then when I did that, I wanted like some nice leads to it. That's when I went, exported the beat and went to Logic and started playing around with it also in Logic. And then that's when this guitar came along, which was also like one of the things that leads the song. Cause it's like, it's just really the chords, but like, you know, I'll finesse the guitar. Yeah, so with that, with the pattern, with that pattern. I was happy, but not really happy. Then I ended up finding this, making this, yeah. Which is like a saxophone. Well, it didn't sound like that at first, but after tweaking it and doing all sorts of things to it, that's how it sounded. And then I added this, which is like, just like a guitar riff, you know, and sliding at the end there, it just sounded so nice. It just sounded so nice. So I just put it in the middle of the beat there, just, you know, to give it just, you know, that extra thing. And stuff, that's when I started arranging my beat. And then when I arranged it, I didn't want to have that, you know, as you can see here, I have this rev here, but when I put that just like that, it sounded nice, but like it was more like, it's like it was a bassy thing to do, you know, so I wanted to find something that would transition the bass nicely when it jumps on the hook, because now the song started with the hook. So I wanted to find something that, you know, the bass, when he drops the bass, it makes a lot more sense. So that's when I ended up making this. Which is like also a Nexus guitar, as you can see. I went here just to make it sound like like someone's playing a guitar, like, you know, a Fender, like, you know. So I used the Nexus bass guitar. And I used that as transition. It sounded much better. And then I added this percussion here on it. And yeah. That was my chorus. And then obviously broke down it to the verse. So when you're making like when you're arranging like a verse and the difference is just, you need to always pick like a sound which is going to be your main, like your main element of a song. For me, that was like, I chose the guitars. It is this one. And this guitar, obviously. So like alone, that when you play without everything else sounds like a beat, so that I wanted that to be like more of the the dominating sound. So I forgot the pad that, you know, I started with. I settled for this. So on the verses, there's that, and obviously the groove, the Afro groove there.
This love nice and crisp. What kind of girl are this? Do you think they no girl can this? You are me reggae girl, I'm your calypso.
I come on and drop the bass again there, you know, story goes on. If I had to pick like something that, you know, I feel like makes the beat more like groovy, better, as like the most catchy element, I pick the guitar, you know. I think the guitar is the most driving thing, like that gives you always the groove, and like, doom, 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 doom. Yeah, because I think without that guitar, it's just another progression, you know. And but that one's like, you know, give it that, you know, you want to dance thing, you know. Otherwise the chords are like very lovey-dovey. You might not just enjoy it when it's just the chords, because me, listen to that with just the chords. But when you add this, it's another story. Like, so yeah, if I had to pick what's actually the like the special ingredient to the song, it has to be the guitar. Before it got out, I knew it was a dub song. You know, I just didn't know how, you know, SA is going to receive it, mostly because, I mean, it's not the sound that's like that was dominating at the time, or still not, is like the sound that people are used to hear of like South African artists making. So I didn't know, but I knew it was a dope song, you know. But when you drop, you know, girls loved it, you know, it's like a very vibey song. I mean, you'd be hating not to like that song. So yeah, a lot of girls liked the song. Then I started hearing it in the club, you know, before you know that song was actually really, you know, just a smash. You know, I still feel like it could have been bigger than what it was. You know, I feel like it was a stepped on song, but yeah. Yeah, so that's exactly how I made Do Better. I showed you all the VSTs I used, all the drums, and yeah, the groove, the tempo, 100 BPM, and the inspiration behind the song. So yeah, that was the recipe behind Do Better. I hope you guys liked it and you learned something from it. Until next time, it's your boy Gemini Major signing out. One time.
While he's made hits across Africa, Gemini is equally technologically skilled. His musicality is further strengthened through technology and fiber. In fact, technology, sound, and perseverance make the recipe for Gemini Major's success.
Broadcast live.